start it with the very first question. What motivated you to venture into solar?
Yes. So when I completed my postgraduate studies and came back to India, the power demand here was increasing significantly. Conventional fuels such as coal and natural gas were unable to meet this demand. On the other hand, India had already become the third largest emitter of greenhouse gases. So solar had a very promising outlook. But when you look at SMEs and entrepreneurs, it was very difficult for them to venture into this. So I decided Karmasukom Energy should be able to help them. And I founded a team in 2014, which was comprising of engineers, which had a strong solar background and global expertise. We then worked with manufacturers from around the world to make complete solutions.
Talking about your startup, how your efforts have turned into achievements in the last 3 years?
So when we started, much of the focus in solar was on large-scale power plants. There was no single policy for rooftop solar. So we started looking at the best practices and energy codes of developed countries like USA, Germany. We interacted with researchers at IIT Powai. And then we decided to set up a state-of-the-art demo center, a training facility, wherein we can bring SMEs who wanted to enter into solar and train them at our facility. 2015, we became the youngest channel partner with the Ministry of Renewable Energy. And together with these partners, till date, we've developed 75 projects across 10 cities in both rural and urban areas.
What are the solutions offered in commercial, industrial and residential sector?
So last year, we were a successful bidder in the Solar Energy Corporation of India rooftop program. This allows us to offer a central financial assistance to residences, primarily independent buildings and also societies. This makes the costing very affordable and reduces the payback to 2 to 3 years. Additionally, we have tied up with financial institutions to offer solar loans for even small sizes such as 1 to 10 kilowatts. For the industrial segment, we have two offerings, a CapEx and the OpEx. The OPEX offering, the customers do not need to purchase the system upfront. It is leased to them in the form of a power purchase agreement. They also, without making any investments, help the environment.
How is Karmasukom Energy helping entrepreneurs and SMEs to venture into solar?
So in 2015, we started what is called the affiliate program. Within this affiliate program, we wanted average installers, young entrepreneurs, regular companies to enter and into this segment of rooftop solar and sell complete packages to their customers. In order to do so, what we did was support them on the technical front. We have sophisticated tools which our team members use to design and develop these systems. And on the marketing front, we are helping them with digital platforms to send out proposals and also help them in terms of their marketing activities.
You are also helping unskilled labor through your installer program. Can you please share an example?
Sure. So as you know, India's population, 50% of it is below the age group of 25. And there's an immense potential for young installers to enter this industry. But this requires a fair amount of training. We've developed a dedicated installer program training module, which allows electricians, also roofers, to enter into the rooftop space. As you know, solar systems can have a long life, but good workmanship can enable that. So what you see behind here is one of such examples of our installer program. And Prince, who has been with us since the last 3 years, has not only been trained by us, he's also trained further more installers.
Komal, being the business analyst, where do you see Karmasukom Energy 5 years from now?
The vision of our company for the next 5 years is to focus on three major areas. Number one being creating energy saving costs for all the households. Number two is to create a sustainable impact on the environment by spreading awareness amongst the youth how solar can positively impact the environment for the future generations to come at large. And finally, the third major point is to reduce the carbon emission footprint, which is the commitment of possibly every citizen of the country and the world to follow this.